What's up, guys? My name is Kira Lynn, and you are watching the New Music Buzz. And on today's show, we have the winner of So You Think You Can Dance. And in our artist spotlight, we have Anthon. Then we talk to Cedric the Entertainer, and he gives us the inside scoop on the Comedy Get Down on BET. So let's get this show on the road. Roll that intro. Season 14 of So You Think You Can Dance has wrapped, and Chanel caught up with the judges and this season's winner. Let's take a look.
America's favorite dancer is Lex.
I do believe America got it more than right. Because I think they chose the best dancer to be number one and the best performer to be number two.
Yes, that's what you said. Koinee was the best performer on the show.
She really was. I think she was fantastic at that. Yeah.
The one thing with Lex that I absolutely love is that he can do all the genres and all the genres well. Tap, hip hop, contemporary.
Maybe not the ballroom. It's
not
samba.
The ballroom, okay.
But I'll tell you what, Lex will now work on ballroom.
Sure. And what advice do you have for Lex moving forward? I mean, you speak with him throughout the season, but what would you say to him now that the show is over?
The big thing now is he's got the tour to do.
Yeah.
But he's going to be offered, I know Desmond Richardson loves him.
Okay.
So he's going to be offered a lot of companies to work with. And it's up to Lex, really. I think, this is just the beginning of Lex's career.
Yeah.
I think Lex, in the last show, went over the top with the comedy piece, and his personality was just, like, out there as far as he's probably ever humanly been out there. And I just think that solidified everything, to tell you the truth. If anybody had any questions there, he was adorable in that piece. And I will watch it again. And anytime I ever feel down, it just makes me laugh out loud. And it was fun to see it again. And, when the producers asked me what I wanted to see, a lot of them were, from past weeks or whatever. And I said, well, is it okay to pick one that's just like last week?
Because
I actually picked that one and Marco. And Koinee doing the hanger number, the closet number, but Marco had picked that, and so, but I said already, I said I wanted Lex in this number. I said okay, because I know we just did it last week. I said, but I'd like to see it again. So they said, yeah, you can have that one. I said, yes, all right.
Girl, you were dreamy and magical on that stage tonight. What was that like?
So surreal. Yeah. So amazing. Like, I love performing. Any chance I get to do that, I'm like, yes.
Yes, and it was nice to see you dance and sing.
Thank you.
I mean, we haven't seen that for a while. You're amazing. What was it like with Robert? Because he's a gorgeous man as well.
I know. It's insane. I've only done one contemporary class in my life. No, I take about two contemporary dance classes. And to be able to work with Mandy Moore, I mean, my mind kind of exploded.
Yeah. The full So You Think You Can Dance experience. You've got it on the chair as a judge and on the stage. That's not fair.
I'm winning.
Are we going to see you next year, Vanessa?
Fingers crossed. I mean, I've loved every single second of this show. That if they said that there was something going on next year, I'd be like, where do I need to show up and when? Because I will be there.
And Lex, did America get it right?
Yes, they 100% did. I mean, he's stupendous in his capabilities and talent. I mean, I'm so proud of him.
It's phenomenal. Yeah. I was saying to Nigel, he's amazing in every genre. He said, except ballroom, he needs to work on that. But
no,
in all genres,
still in ballroom,
yeah,
still.
But so good as an all-rounder dancer.
I know, and I think that's what sets him apart. Like, to be able to do everything and to have faith in yourself, like whether or not he pats himself on the back, he knows that he can do it, and he does do it, and he shows the world, and it's been like an incredible thing to be a part of.
I mean, I know it hasn't sunk in yet. It's literally just happened, but what's going through your mind?
Yikes, there's a lot. Definitely not sinking in at all. It's very surreal and unbelievable.
Yeah. looking back on this whole journey, I mean, every dance you performed has been spectacular.
Oh, thank you.
But if you had to look back and think of one word or one moment in particular that really sums it up for you, because season 14, it's an incredible, incredible title to have as the winner.
I mean, yikes. I don't know if I could pinpoint one thing, but I mean, definitely like being able to dance with Gabby was definitely like something else. She's definitely someone that can do everything, and that's something I strive for, and being able to dance with her and enjoy dancing with her was absolutely amazing.
That's the thing I've said both to Nigel and Vanessa, is that you are one of the dancers who could do every genre and every genre well. I mean, tapping in particular, because that's a tough one. Not everyone can do that.
I mean, I try. I'm not so sure if I executed it like to my fullest potential, but like I tried.
America thought so.
Holy yikes.
And we have to know, this is $250,000. That's a lot of money, Lex, and you can be proud of that. So what are you going to do with that money?
I have no clue. I'm definitely saving most of that money so I don't touch it and be reckless, but definitely doing a little bit of a splurge fee, like maybe on like some shopping or maybe take
first thing to your mind for shopping.
Yeah, some nice kicks.
Yeah. And next for you, what's happening next? Because now you guys have been out for like how long now? 6 weeks? 7 weeks?
And then we start tour rehearsal tomorrow at 9 a.m. And we have 5 days to build a tour and we're off.
Then you're off. Wow. Well, you have an incredible journey. You're amazing. America loves you and all the best. Lovely to have spoken to you for all these weeks.
Thanks.
So well done. That's a wrap here, guys. That's season 14 of So You Think You Can Dance. Lex is our winner. I hope you've enjoyed our backstage coverage, because I've so enjoyed bringing you the exclusives. We'll see you guys next year. I'm Chanel Herlin, and you've just been buzzed.
Hey, my name is Vanessa Hudgens, and you've just been buzzed.
After the break, we have Anthony in our artist spotlight.
Go to cityloan.com or call 877-553-9071 to borrow $3,000 or more with the equity in your payoff vehicle. Your car is your credit. With City Loan, over 99% of City Loan customers are in good standing every month. So call 877-553-9071 now, and if you sign up for a loan, you're going to receive a free gift card. Don't forget to mention promo code TVAD to receive your gift card, and also don't forget to follow City Loan and Facebook at City Loan Community, and follow us on Twitter at City Loan. Now back to the New Music Buzz.
Hi, my name is Anson.
My name is Zach.
And we're Anson, and you're watching The Bubble. We came up with the band name, well, because first off, it actually wasn't supposed to be a band project. It was supposed to be my solo project. I was looking for maybe 2 years for band members, and I kind of got fed up, and I was like, fuck it, I'm going to name it my name, Anson. And the irony of that is that maybe 2 months later after I did that, I met Zach over here and George, and now we're a band, so that's what the name's about.
Yeah, and the name Butthole Surfers was already taken.
Yeah, so unfortunately we couldn't use that name either, so yeah. For me, I guess someone that really thought to myself, like, hey, we got something here in terms of a sound, it probably was To Be or Nothing at All. That song really was the beginning. I just started writing this kind of music, and that was the first one I really kind of explored with and dabbled to get to the sound that we have now.
Yeah, that was the first song you sent to me too, was To Be. But I would have to say my favorite that I'm most excited about is Sober Living on the EP that comes out on the 29th.
The song's about living a normal life. It's not about like being sober and like drugs. It's more about like doing the typical 9-to-5 day job, and basically kind of hating yourself for it because you have like this, you know, this musical passion and you want to pursue it, but you're too scared to, and you have like, you know, like a lack of confidence in yourself to do it. So for me, that's what the song Sober Living is about, and that's why it's called Sober Living. I broke down, kinda sing about just staring at the paper, thinking life turn around. I keep calling, searching through the distance, is anyone listening? Sometimes we all need a second to breathe. I was never the best, and never was the best. No, the title track is To Be or Nothing at All. And that song's about just having a lack of inspiration. I mean,
well, yeah, and like when we talked about it before, it was originally untitled, but then we just kept thinking like there was a gap, and like we're very into Shakespeare, and it's like loosely alluding to Shakespeare, and
To be or not to be kind of ish. It basically essentially means like, follow your dreams, don't fucking sit on a couch and eat chips all day and watch TV. Like, if you actually believe in yourself, don't, and you have a dream, believe in yourself and have confidence and fucking pursue that, so.
Unless they're Cool Ranch Doritos.
Unless they're Cool Ranch Doritos, and then in that case, then you should probably keep eating.
Yeah.
Ooh.
I would say probably, like, modern emo. Not emo, like, screaming or anything like that, but, like, emotionally driven and something to say and heart on your sleeve, lots of guitars.
Emo rock, alternative rock. Some people have been talking and saying we're pop punk. I'm not entirely sure if that's necessarily true. I mean, I love Blink-182, and there definitely are certain parts of, like, for example, like To Be or Nothing at All, in the bridge we have like that crazy like phaser part, but it's very feel this. I guess I'd say alternative alt rock, like, but definitely more towards the emo area of things. 2017 emo, I'll take that, yeah.
We are discussing tours. We can't go too much into that right now, but there's a bunch of things on the table we're trying to sort out. We want to hit the road. We're already writing the next EP.
We have B-sides coming out too. We don't have a date yet for them, but we have a shit ton of B-sides coming out, and then another record.
Yeah, we've been super, super busy.
We're looking to do our first show sometime in October, though. We have a couple that we've been talking about, but we want to do it right after the EP release to get people stoked, because we want to see all of you guys on the stage. Well, at the show. What am I saying? so soon.
We'll be on the stage.
Yeah, we'll be on the stage. You guys will be in the crowd. It'll be good. Good vibes all around.
We play things. You shout.
Yeah, we've...
That's
it's soon. Soon. That's all I can say. You can follow us at Anson Official. So basically all of our tags for Instagram, Snapchat, Twitter, Facebook, it's all YouTube, Anson Official. So A-N-S-O-N and then the word official. Or check out our website, AnsonOfficial.com. Hi, my name's Anson.
My name is Zach.
And you've been buzzed.
After the break, we have Cedric the Entertainer. But first, let's check out the videos that dropped this week. Lay out my goodbyes, I'm done for the night. Saw you outside, has a look in your eyes. Falling in a deep no, getting late, I have to go. I can't leave, I have to know. Get into my car, get into my life. I got the sauce, I got the spice. She bet I hit it twice. Yeah. Rolling, 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 rolling like a stoner. Rolling like a stoner. Rolling like a stoner. I got a problem nobody knows. Rolling like a stoner. Rolling like a stoner. Oh, I probably would stay in school. Codeine and orange. That's my formula, I don't want baby food. I don't eat baby food. I don't eat baby food.
put a O in front of Range Rover. That's an orange coat. That's a strange coat. That's an orange Range Rover coat. That's an orange Rover. That's a fruit. Y'all so cute together. She for you. She a suit on the boot. 1800 tequila. Lady like Peter Boo. Peter Boo star. She for him. She for me. She for you. No SG. Not a crew. We a team. Not a crew.
Starting NTR was beginning that path of discovering what is in our everyday lives, what are we eating, what products are we using, what thoughts are we having that are toxic, that are linked to disease, and how can we lower our risk by reducing our exposure to these toxins.
We're talking shampoo, conditioner, this, that, this, that, and no one thinks about or thinks about exactly what's in there.
Like, I believe in fairness and I believe in justice. And when I started learning and discovering about the chemicals that were in our everyday products that were linked to causing cancer, I got super pissed.
Revolution is a big word, but I think honestly that's exactly what it's going to have to be and what it's starting to be with people who are questioning what companies are putting in their products.
So whether it is, you know, people who are just using their purchasing power, whether it's working with other advocacy groups to change the laws, there's so many different ways, but ultimately the goal is to not have it be legal to have all these chemicals in our products and in our foods that are causing us disease.
Corporations aren't going to change those ingredients unless we demand that they do.
That's the unique thing that NTR does, is that it's taking all this jargon and information that sometimes might be hard to understand and is giving it to people in very digestible and very receptive ways.
It's going to be a changed world, and that's what a revolution is. It changes something that's status quo, and we need those things to be changed.
The Comedy Get Down tour took place earlier this year, and BET thought it would be a good idea to make a show about the tour and the behind the scenes. We were at the Paley Center, where Cedric the Entertainer stopped by and gave us the details.
The Comedy Get Down is about me, Cedric the Entertainer, and my show with guys like George.
The Comedy Get Down is about me and my tour with these four other kids.
No, hang on, dude.
The Comedy Get Down is about me doing comedy with four underlings.
Comedy Get Down is about your boy Charlie Murphy, period.
Hold that thought. The Comedy Get Down tour is about your boy Eddie Griffin, no, killing it every night.
That's what you think I'm in this airport club, motherfucker. This is a show jacket.
What the fuck is belt and straps, man? What straps? What is straps, man? What's on me? What's on me? Look like a straps.
You know what I'm saying, Charlie? 80.
the show Comedy Get Down is about the tour that these five comedians went on. So the show's very funny.
What was your reaction to it? What were some memorable moments?
It's just great seeing these guys together. And, you know, it's really sad that Charlie Murphy passed. But this was filmed before he passed away. But it's just great seeing these guys interact with each other and seeing them on the road. And they're all funny guys. So when they get started, it's hilarious.
You know, you have had such a long career and you're constantly, you know, still relevant, still having diehard fans. It must feel amazing. Who's someone on your radar, though, that's coming up in comedy that, you know, you're like, okay, I can see them, like, you know, maybe having the same long-lasting career?
Probably, you know, the guy that's, you know, that I kind of see, that kind of I take a liking to, he feels a lot like me, is Lil Rel. Lil Rel Howery, you know, he's having a good time. He's on the Carmichael Show. He now has a cool little pop on Insecure. And he's a funny stand-up, man. He's from the Midwest, you know, and he just kind of reminds me. He's got that good spirit, good attitude about it, and, you know, that kind of positive focus. And so, I'm rooting for him, and I wish him well. And he's one of my little guys.
I love Lil Rel. I feel like he has like a genuine like energy, you know, but he's still funny, and I actually see that with you as well. So I can see why you know kind of like him too. How is this tour gonna compare to Kings of Comedy?
You know, this tour, I mean, the thing about the Kings of Comedy, we kind of lived in a time when that was not even, you know, even thought of, for, you know, all these comedians to get together and go out. And, you know, and then we were doing arenas at that time, and it, you know, it was only rare that someone would even do an arena before then. It was like, it was you know, Eddie Murphy, Martin Lawrence, and then we went out as a group. So now, you know, it feels like, you know, you had the emergence of Kevin Hart's and Cat Williams, and so people, you know, they love the big showcase comedy. And so I think that is, you know, the thing that that will make this not quite as the thing as the Kings of Comedy, but people love to see us all together.
Something that we wouldn't expect about George Lopez.
George Lopez has a very big heart. He's also very politically ferocious.
Right.
And I personally respect that. I love someone that's like, yes, I'm a public person, but I'm still going to speak out about injustice. I try to be that person myself. He has zero chill. Mm-hmm. He's savage with his, and I love that.
Yeah. He really uses his platform, you know, for
change for other people. It's not enough to be okay if other people are not okay. And this man is rich and successful and doesn't have to speak up about the plight of his people or the plight of anything that's happening in the world. And yet he decides, I'm going to do it anyway. And I just saw a great quote from Muhammad Ali that talked about that. He was like, I could lose everything. I could lose my life, but my people are suffering. And so I'm going to use my platform for this. And I think that's where we are. That's what Kaepernick is doing. That's what George is doing. That's what I'm trying to do. You have to use the platform you have to help the people that can't speak up for themselves.
Absolutely. Yeah. Get this word, you guys. I know you haven't seen the tour yet, but is there a favorite comedian that you're maybe looking forward to the most?
Oh gosh, I can't do that. I love them all. They're all good and they're great in their own ways. Like, it's hard to pick. How do you pick from these five men? Rest in peace, Mr. Murphy. But, you know, they're all just amazing. So I can't pick.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Well, thank you so much. You look stunning. And enjoy tonight.
Do you guys know what this is all about?
No.
Okay, listen up. Effective today, 50 Cent will be taking over operations at BET. All of you now report to the cast of 50 Central.
Ms. Lee, this is highly unorthodox.
Security, get him out of here.
Yo, man, come on, man.
From now on,
Deborah.
Biddy's in charge.
Hey, Weitzman, look at me. I am the captain now.
How did he do it? How did he do it?
I did what you said, so let me go.
Don't worry, Deb, we got you.
Curtis, this is some bullshit.
50 Central, starring Shiv, Wednesday, September 27th at 10:30.
Marilyn Manson's concert in New York City came to a halt when two giant gun props came crashing down on him, sending the rocker to the hospital. Manson was reportedly about an hour into his show at the Manhattan Center Hammerstein Ballroom, performing Sweet Dreams Are Made of This, when the stage prop fell on top of him. According to various reports, it took several minutes for emergency workers to get Manson out from under the props, and he was put on a stretcher and taken to the hospital. No word yet on Manson's injuries, but the rest of the show was canceled. This is Kira Lynn, and you've just been buzzed. That's all we have. Special thanks to Lex Ishimoto, So You Think You Can Dance, Fox, Anson, Chanel Herlin, Lima Hassana, and the Paley Center. Don't forget to like us on Facebook, tweet us at Twitter, and double tap us on Instagram, all at the New Music Buzz. My name is Kira Lynn. Peace out, guys.
I think he's incredibly intelligent. I think he makes very smart choices. He is an absolute worker. He never complains about anything. Like, literally,
when he's injured.
He popped his shoulder out and he was stood next to me and I got my arm around him. Shaking. And I kept saying to him, are you all right? And when it would cut off me, I'd say to them, I'm gonna send him off. And he felt like he was going to faint or something like that. And I phoned every day after that to make sure he was okay. But it is a whole thing where he's got the whole package.
Yeah,
so
he does.
I think they did get it right.
And we saw tonight everyone's favorite routine, favorite moment. Mm-hmm. So what was your favorite moment, a highlight in the whole season?
Oh, my goodness.
A tough one, I know.
That is really hard. Oh, my goodness.
The New Music Buzz is brought to you by Monster Products, pure Monster quality with Monster sound, Rock and Roller Suitcase Turntables, Vinyl's new best friend, and City Loan. Get cash for your car today. For more music entertainment news, go to www.thenewmusicbuzz.com.
Peace out.